Hello and welcome to part 25 of IR Revision 2. The last part we started our revenge on Andras, who wanted to do something really bad to Mika, but we are currently in the process of cracking him, or is cracking him. I need to get down to the deepest depths, somewhere where a routine scan wouldn't usually look. Implant spyware in such a place and intelligence gathering will be child's play. Even manipulation of the victim's subconsciousness becomes possible. Spyware, software that can record a user's actions and personal information or steal microprocessor time for other calculations. It operates in locations unseen by the end user and often goes unnoticed. This recorded information or calculation results are then sent to the spyware source. Let's make sure he never messes with us again. It just takes a little bit of time and work to get to a proper death, so I tell my comrades to make sure he doesn't get anywhere in the meantime. Andras is down on one knee as he grimaces and presses down upon his temples. He appears to be in shock, but he doesn't realize his microtrigger has been hacked. The criminal member surround Andras with their guns drawn. The only one unarmed, Magdalene, glares at him from a few steps back. Unconsciously lifts up her gun in a gesture, causing her aim on Andras to stray. The very next instant, Andras stands up and makes a run for it. The imitation bullet mildly fires from the mechanical bell, skims beside Andras, grazes his nose and hits the sprinkler system. Water rains down from the ceiling. Andras crumples down to the floor as he presses down on his nose. It was only a scratch, but hey. Soon he jumps like a cat into the cover of a minivan parked in the lot. Andras leans against a nearby car and takes something out of his pocket. Then he turns back and... When he turned back, his face was pale in pain and fear, but Andras' expression gradually loosens into one of pleasure and joy. His hollow eyes stare off blankly into the distance. What is this? Lemchan? Here? Hickles hops onto his bike with gun in hand. And then... Alright, and take out the two badges, actually just electronic tools I've prepared beforehand. One red and one blue. Just as a little something special for Andras, the badges are illustrated with Lemchan art. The red one is spyware, all audiovisual data, take the pertaining the keyword scouts and enlil are automatically sent to criminals. One down. Moving on to the preparations for the other batch. I wonder how the others are holding up. Kosuke starts approaching Anders when Anders springs up and lunges at Kosuke. Kosuke is taken by surprise and gets pushed down. The cornered red will divide the cat, they say. Hängen weg, I guess. Andras grabs onto Kosuke's stare auge. Ork. The two begin a tug of war match over the gun. We are roughly equal in strength. Going by physical alone, Kosuke should be stronger, but right now, it's as if Andras is being augmented by some sort of limited release. After some struggling, Kosuke kicks Andros in the knee. However, it's not very effective due to Andros' apparently dull sense of pain. You mean you just used drugs? Both of them become drenched with sweat. Neither are willing to yield. Kosuke suddenly lets go of a rifle. Andros flies backward. With his unopposed pulling force further fueling his fall, Andros backs his head against the car parked behind him. Consequently, he drops the rifle he had just taken away. You're too much, my dude. Andros takes a small paper bundle out of his jacket pocket. As Andros focused on the paperback, Kosuke strikes that opening to rush in and take back the gun. But before he can, Andros kicks the Auge away from Kosuke's hand, dropping the paper bundle in the process of them. Mika dives in and steals it from the side. Andros gets at Mika with bloodshot eyes. Kosuke used shoulder attack. With the side set on nothing but the sack of drugs, Andros is taken down easily. With a face full of disgust, Mika hurls the sack contents to the floor. With his clenched and rage, he tramples it underfoot. You have enough money to do things like that. Don't cry over money. Andros goes after Mika again. Andros takes an anti-riot rubber bullet to the back and to the shoulder, goes tumbling down, but soon enough he tumbles into space between the two cars. Andros keeps running from car to car, pulling on whatever door handles he can get a hold of. And eventually he finds a black SUV, left carelessly unlocked. Andros rips open the door and hops right in. Kosuke rushes over in a panic, but Andros has already locked the door. And it doesn't end there. He ignites the engine in an attempt to possibly rip Kosuke off the door. Kosuke quickly jumps away, just in the nick of time. Yeah, at this rate he's going to get away. Kosuke straddles his bike and chases after the car. As for me, the blue Lem Chan badge is for stalking protection. Whenever he tries to recall information regarding a criminal, especially regarding Magdalene, he will be inflicted with extreme nausea. I'm sure that it'll stop him from attacking us anymore. Car horns, lights and alarms start going haywire all across the lot. I see, the double are hijacking and manipulating the other cars through the net. Quite a distance away, a white sedan and a silver station wagon ignite the engines. Meanwhile, Andros' SUV makes a mad dash. The white sedan charges in to block the SUV from the front left. Andros makes a sharp turn to avoid it, but now the silver station wagon strikes from the front right. Kosuke's bike chases from behind. Andros' scream can be heard from the outside of the car. He turns away from the station wagon at full throttle. He drifts slip. The two cars rushing into block Andros from both sides are unable to slow down. And then Kosuke charging from behind. Thumbs down in an attempt to avoid two abruptly stopping cars. Ah, the picture's back on. Looks like the transmitter's okay. But wow, Kosuke is pretty good at attacking tumbles. Guess he's used to it. And was Love's triumphant Love's triumphant laugh and escapes in the SUV. Guess there's no more need for biocomputer abuse now.
このぐらいでいいかな。
そうね。感じバッチリに危機感を味合わせられたし、作戦成功ですね。
リーダー、任務完了です。このままミカゾを連れてマンションに戻ります。
お疲れ様。みんなありがとう。ミカも無事でよかった。
先輩、リーダー、車ぐしゃぐしゃになっちゃいましたが。
ああ、車の持ち主には悪いことしちゃったけど。あれの修理代は全部アンドラスの口座から引き落としといてあげる。
ふげ、いくらになるんだろう。
まあ、あそこは金持ちのボンボンだから、ポケットマネーで十分なんじゃないの。
I wonder if this will be enough for Andras. But far more importantly, we now have a way to figure out Code's actions. Date 4042, 5th of May. Cluster 7, Route B.
それでは、我がクリミナルの完全勝利を祝って。
Garbage. Let me. Okay, we're close to a new moon.The 5th of May. Something interesting happening at the 5th of May? The attack on Babel. And now a toast to our grand victory here at Criminal.
Cheers.
Since we successfully suppressed Andras, gave him his just desserts and saved Mika, we decided to celebrate with a toast at our favorite Monjaki joint. Monjaki. A Tokyo specialty mainly popular among young women. You are presented with batter and various uncooked ingredients, which you may then mix in according to your liking. It's similar to Okonomiyaki, a Japanese dish, similar to a pancake with various ingredients mixed in. But unlike okonomiyaki, you must never let it solidify. It's meant to be eaten in a semi-fluid state.
やっぱり大きな仕事の後の一杯は最高だね。
どうぞ、もう一杯。
お、気が利くね。じゃ、駆けつけ3杯といきますか。
Aomi takes the empty glass and fills it to the brim.
おっとと、こぼれちゃうじゃない。
I rush in to suck up the foam, and then I chuck down the rest.
Ah, いい気分。
さすがリーダー、いい飲みっぷりですね。
先輩、これってオレンジジュースですよね。
Yes, this is orange juice. Nothing else.
ん？そうだけど、どうかしたの？
We're all underage here, so alcohol is obviously illegal for us. Criminals practices strict discipline.
なんか。ビール飲んでるみたいですよ。だって今日はそんな気分でしょ。
So you just think about it, but you really are just drinking orange juice, okay?
しかしジュースで酔っ払った気分ってわかるもんなんですか。
そんなの勢い。
おやおや、タルちゃんたち、ずいぶんご機嫌だね。
あ、おばちゃん、今日は仕事がうまくいってさ。
そりゃよかったじゃないか。はい、ご注文のイカスミマーボ
ー。待ってました。
リーダー、そういうの好きですよね。
何か文句でも。コウスケ君は嫌いなの。
あ、いや、そうじゃないけどさ、たまにはこうエビとか牛肉とか普通のものも食べたいなとか。
もんじゃに普通なんてないわよ。それにこれも美味しいんだからいいじゃないの。
まあまあ、そういうこうちゃんのために。はい。
うわー、海鮮デラックスじゃないですか。
これは私からのお祝い。
え、いいの？やったー。だからおばちゃん大好き。
今後ともごひいきに。
はーい。
じゃあ今日はみんな遠慮しないでどんどん食べよう。
おう。
In front of us. Either sides are rows of ingredients of all colors. awaiting for us with her savory scents, all contrasting with each other, and with her jet black squid ink monja.
この鉄板平原に生地の湖を形成し、美味しそうな具たちを湖ごと体内に回収することよ。
We are afraid about this, I think. Ah, it's just the same. Just shorted.
ガッテン!
無駄口叩いてないでさっさと混ぜる!
へいへい!
は
っ!
やっ! ほい! はへ! よしよし、皆の衆、その調子!
I scrap up the edge and bring it to my mouth. The rich, salty taste of the squid ink, doban jiang, light fluffiness of the tofu, the crunch texture of the cauterized batter.
Yappari koko no monja wa umai to!
Ah, leader! Nani hitori de tabe hajimete run desu ka?
Ah, barete. Ah, yumi mo yumi mo! So ne.そろそろ食べ頃かも。コウスケは作る専門ね。
なんで？
海鮮もいいわね。
Batter with dashi and sauce really brings out flavor of shrimp, squid and scallops.
ってそれ、おばちゃんが俺のために持ってきてくれたやつですよ。
男なら細かいことは気にしなさんなって。
あんたら本当に仲がいいね。
違いますよ。
Oh, so we say, but they pipe down just like this.
Mmm, oishikatta. Yappa monja wa koko ni kagiru ne.
Honto, omowazu tabesugichatte, onaka ga panpan desu.
Ore, mou hitotsu tanomou kana.
Mada taberu no?
Kosuke-kun, aikawarazu sugoi shokuyoku da yo ne.
Shokuyoku ga aru no wa genki na shouko. Ningen kenkou na no ga ichiban da yo.
True.
So desu ne.ユミもそう思います。
悩んでた件も一件落着したし、これで一安心よね。
本当に、やっと安心して仕事に打ち込めます。先輩、みんな、ありがとう。
仲間として当然のことをしたまでさ。
うんうん。困った時は助け合いの精神です。
これで、またミカと張り合えるってもんだしね。
Each member cooperates to help each other out. It's like a second nature to a criminal. Makes me proud. Everyone's really growing up.
Problem も解決したことだし、この調子でコードも一網打尽にするよ。
Masami's already set her sights on her next target. True, that is the problem. I'd like to settle sooner rather than later, but we're dealing with terrorists here. I need to remind her of that.
無理は禁物。一人で突っ走っちゃダメ。
そうだぞサミゾ、俺たちはチームなんだからやるときはみんなでやろうぜ。
こればかりはコウスケに賛成ね。ユミも一緒に頑張るからみんな。
もう分かったわよ、一人で手を出したりなんかしません。よしよし、いい子ね。
I embrace Masami and pat her on the head.I'm glad to have strong, matured friends by my side, but my real intention here is not to put anyone in danger anymore.
Oba-chan, gochisousama!
Minna, mata oide yo ne! Tappuri service shite agiru kara ne!
Hai! Hontou ni oishikatta desu!
Yaa, kutta kutta!
Anta tabe sugi! Are kara mata monja, hitori de 2 mai mo tsuika shite!
Sono uchi ushi ni naru wa yo!
なんだと？
もうなってる。
We just came here for lunch, but it's already well past sunset. About time we step a foot out of a store. Now that's awkward.
今日はお祝いの席だし、残業はなしということで現地解散といたしますか。
そうね。ユミはまた本屋に寄っていくの？うん。今日は欲しかった。チャペック童話選手の発売日だし。
ユーミンは本当本好きだな。
あなたも少しは見習いなさい。
なんじゃその鳴き声は。
じゃあみんなで寄っていきませんか。
そうしましょうか先輩。
そうね、たまにはいいかもね。
I was skimming through some technical texts while waiting for Mayumi to book out her book, but... Kosuke hasn't moved at all from the manga corner, which doesn't seem to please Masami at all.
うん、今はパス。かな。残念です。3分子の限定と言われる刺繍ですごく面白いんですよ。Sounds a little too refined for my taste.
I'm a little uneasy since she's done it before, but I need to make sure.
いえ、安心してください。久しぶりに書店に行って家の本が懐かしくなっただけですから。いろいろ読み返してみます。うちにもいっぱい置いていかなかったっけ？あれでもまだ3分の1くらいです。あれ以上持っていくと先輩の部屋が埋まっちゃいますし。
It's a little hard for me to imagine all those books. But whatever, it doesn't look like she's citing anything at least. Oh, it doesn't look like she's regained all of her usual cheer either.
うん、分かった。それじゃあみんな、また明日ね。
I see everyone off and for the first time in a long time, have a refreshing solitary walk back. Today all members return to their respective homes, invisible files, leaving me with a rare night to myself. Room is saturated with silence, save for a melody of water droplets. It's not bad at all to have some alone time every now and then, to enjoy nature's ambient soundtrack. I had a convenience store boxed lunch for dinner, so it's not like we're here to retrieve the tableware. Parcel delivery? I connect my room monitor to the front door surveillance camera. Reflected on screen is... It's terribly tattered. His face is swollen from someone hitting him. His whole body is soaked since he's been out without an umbrella.
それは構わないけど、どうしたのその格好。一体何があったっていうの？それは。
It seems to be in some sort of situation.
すいません、リーダー。
I hurry to the washroom for a bath towel and drape it over his head.
ほら、さっさと温まっておいで。
Kosuke wipes his body apologetically and disappears in the bathroom. He must be frozen to the core. I should prepare a warm drink for him. I guess coffee will do. I'm pretty sure the stuff should be on his on the shelf. It should be here. Why can't I find it? I always get Yumi or Mika to prepare it, so there has to be some. Where's that can? Can here? Oh wait, this is cacao. Cocoa. Not what what I was playing on, but I can't find the coffee, so.
こっちの方がいいよね。
I asked myself for approval. Approval granted. First, let's take out the mug. Pretty sure I can just put the cocoa powder in here and then fill it with hot water. I don't want it to get cold, so I guess I should do that once Kosuke gets out of the bath. I chill the can of cocoa above the cup and... Oh, nuts, I've really done it now. The cup gets half buried in powder. As does the surrounding area on the table.
やっぱ慣れないことするとろくなことないな。今度ユミにココアの入れ方くらい聞いておこう。
I cheerfully scoop up several spoonfuls from the cup and return it to the can. As for the powder on the table, too much of a bother. I just suck it up with a hand cleaner. But still, I wonder what happened to Kosuke. He wouldn't come to my place if it were just any fight. Which can only mean one thing. And glance at the clock. Kosuke has been in the bathroom for about 20 minutes. can still hear a shower. No signs of stopping. Kosuke's probably crying. But he probably doesn't want me to see him like that. So he's just trying to wash it all away. Well, that's the sort of impression I get at least. He may act differently, but with a Shinozuka double, but he usually doesn't try to put on any ass around him and me. This is probably what they call a man's spirit. Well, let's just wait for him. The night's still young. I've got plenty of time to hear his story.
Ah, ii o yu deshita.
Kosuke finally comes out of a bath tube. I pour the hot water into cocoa powder. Since I'm pouring from a pot, I shouldn't have to worry about scalding myself as long as I'm careful. I hand Kosuke the hot cocoa I slave over.
Ah, sumimasen.
Kosuke takes a tiny sip from a cup. He smiles feebly, probably because of his swollen face. This is as suspected. Well, I had him pinned down at 50-50 on whether he'd be honest about it or not. I ask with a cherubic look on my face. Kosuke just hangs his head and refuses to speak. Looks like he's unsure whether or not to continue. Finally, Kosuke looks up. You say. Not everyone knew this, but we knew it. Kosuke's eye pop up at my nonchalant response, but after a quick reconsideration, he begins to lightly scratch his hand. Looks like he saw right through me too. We look at each other in the face and exchange some awkward laughter. And eventually, Kosuke regains his resolve and begins to speak again.
だからうちには笑いなんていうものはなきに等しかった。でもおじいちゃんが大好きだった。ユーモアがあってお話が大好きで、おじいちゃんのおかげで俺は明るくやってこれたんだと思う。そうだったの。うちの親父もおじいちゃんぐらい寛容だったらよかったのに。それで何があったの？気づいていたと思うんですけど、この間の犯罪者リスト。
The son of the cyber foresight leaked intel. Can someone guess what the consequences would be like? There's nothing more I can say. Regardless of the details, I'm indirectly responsible for the leakage of classified information. I could very well be charged of a felony if I'm not careful. I gave our team the name Criminal as a constant warning of how close we are to committing these sorts of crimes, but... Kosuke puts down the mug, with hands shaking ever so slightly.
That's
Criminal's Creed, I mention whenever I get the chance, and this is how Kosuke put into practice his own interpretation of his words. It takes all I have to resist the urge to hug Klaus.
Cyber Force no Black List no naka de zutto grey zone ni douroku sarete iru desu ne. Ano file de shirimashita.
Not silently.
Ore wo criminal ni ireta no wa moshikashitara keisatsu no musuko dakara kuwaite okeba tashou wa tsukamari nikuku naru darou toiu tachiba teki na ryuu dake nano kamoshirenai.
Giku giku giku.
The reason we invited Kosuke was because he seemed like someone who could provide sufficient backup. But I can't completely deny the reason he mentioned it either.
Demo ore datte member toshite ore ni shika yarenai koto ga aru.
Kosuke suddenly looks me in the face. Ore wa otoko
toshite member toshite leader wo eien ni grey zone made de todome black zone ni otosanai gimu ga aru.
Places his hand to his chest like a knight swearing an oath before a princess.
Criminal wa ore ga mamoru dekiru kagiri no chikara wo tsukushite.
Kou-chan.
Those words strike the depths of my heart. Before I realize it, I'm swept away by emotions, like always, and embrace him. Kou-chan pats me on the back, as if to soothe me. This moment marks the birth of criminals, Low Knight. Date 2032, 7th of May, Cluster 8, Route B. We're not here to eat Monja today. We're here to introduce Nergal to the new customer I promised him. It is to Masami.
Hora, koko yo. Shino Jujiro tte.
Kore, junk shop janai desu ka?
Omote muki wa ne. Ma, mitame wa ayashii komoshirenai kedo. Utsuide ni tenshu wa.
まあ、リーダーの推薦ですから信用はしますけど。やっほー。イシュトルが待ってたぞ。約束通り、電脳修理のお客さんよ。篠塚まさみです。よろしくお願いします。ああ、よろしく。早速だが。
お嬢ちゃんは ここに必要事項を記入しておいてくれ。
Nergal takes the medical records like printout out of a document folder and hands it to Masami.
あ、はい。でも本当に助かりました。電脳って合法スレスレだから普通のお医者さんじゃ見てもらえないし、入れたのは海外だったから。
Masami quickly fills out the form and hands it back to Nergal as he speaks.
腕はともかく。
あまり程度の良くないところでつけたんだろう。故障してなくとも元々調整が必要だ。ここは違うんですか？有料だが、アフターサポートもきっちりしてる。他に問題はなしと。右手奥にドアがあるから中で待っててくれ。オッケー。さ、行きましょう、サミ。はい、リーダー。
Inner room looks like a lab. Sure gives the junk shop facade a whole new layer of sketchiness. It indeed does look really, really strange to have something like that under your scrap shop. The inner room looks like a lab. Sure gives the junk shop facade a whole new layer of sketchiness.
こんなに広いスペースがあるんだ。本当ね。これだけ広々としてるんだったら、店舗の方をもうちょっと広げたらよかったのに。余計なお世話だ。さて、お嬢ちゃんはそこに横になってくれ。Masami
lies down on the examination table as told. Nergal puts on latex gloves, promptly opens up her biocomputer maintenance hatch, and peeks inside.
主要回線が3本。 CPU が焼き切れたか。これで脳に衝撃がいかなかったってのは安全装置の出来とそれに運が良かったんだな。え、そんなに悪いんですか？
Masami is visibly flustered. I know how bad it was beforehand, but kept silent so as to not disturb her.
ショートしてる部分が神経との接合部にかなり近い。もしそっちに火花が飛んでたら命があったかどうか微妙なところだ。
Yes, biocomputerization brings constant risk of danger. That's why I told back Sami's recklessness. Hold back Sami's recklessness. Hopefully this will send a message to her to collect herself a little.
幸いメモリには障害はないようだ。修理といってもパーツの交換だけだから安心しな。
That said, Nurgle begins preparations. About half of a biocomputer is connected to the nurse, so the biocomputer repair and maintenance has a surgical aspect to it.
麻酔はいらないな。 お嬢ちゃん、 心の準備はいいか? よかったら始めるぞ。
そんな…
心配するな。 脳にはもともと痛覚がない。 麻酔の副作用の方が有害だ。
まさか… 拒絶反応抑制剤も使わないんですか?
That's what I'd like to ask. Every hospital and back LA doctor uses immunosuppressants for cybernetic procedures.
お嬢ちゃんくらいサイバーウェアの適合性が高いなら、そんなものは必要ない。でも…
Nurgle suddenly starts taking off his surgical gloves.
いきなりどうしたの?
俺の腕が信用できないって言うんなら、帰ってもらおう。
そんな…
That's Nurgle's pride. Outward pride and everything will come to nothing.
Sami-chan? ネルガルはできないことをできるとは言わない。その彼ができると断言してるのだから心配ないわ。わかりました。それじゃあお願いします。Okay,
even if the people there are very skilled and have really good equipment, I would really really be scared to do this.
そうかい?
Yes, and I heard that there is some stuff with brain science. Okay, this should possibly do a robot or something like that. But it isn't that scary to do it in the future if something like this happens with microchips to our brains. With an extremely disappointed look on his face, he slowly starts replacing his latex gloves.
はい、はい、わかりました。じゃあこっちはお任せあり。
This is one of his times you just can't refuse your good old friends, even if they are not selling anything. And still I dive right in, pounding my chest and pride.
よろしくね。
Masami looks at me with moist eyes. I guess despite outward appearances, things really do get scary when you get down to them.
大丈夫。私が知る限り、ネルガルが一度でもヘマをやらかしたことはないわ。俺はお前の知らない所でもミスしたことはないぞ。だってさ、わかりました。よろしくお願いします。
I wave goodbye to Masami lying on the operation table and head off to 10th shop for the first time in what seems like forever. Really, really scary position.
これなんかいかがでしょう。全く持って使えない代物ですが、ニヤニヤ。さすがお客さん、お目が高い。はい、ありがとうございます。また来てくださいね。はい、終わったぞ。
After about 2 hours, Nurgle finally comes out from the back room.
本当?ありがとう。オペは完璧だ。
今すぐスキップしながらでも帰ってもらったって結構だ。ほいほーい。
And cheerfully head off to meet Masami.
Sami, 私がわかる?
Masami sits up when she hears my voice, but loses her balance.
おっとっと。
I support Masami by the back so she doesn't fall over. I thought Nurgle didn't use anesthetics, so what's going on? Masami looks kinda half asleep. Maybe the brain or biochip, the biocomputer maybe simulated this effect? The expression makes her resemble her sister Mayumi a little more than usual, which is somewhat strange. She says something ambiguous without showing any change in her expression. Nurgle laughs in astonishment. A lone woman. Did someone hack their way in through the network?
乗っ取られたりしなかった？
それは全く。
ここは完全に電波を遮断するシェルターになってる。そんなことは物理的にありえん。
その人、彼が与えたこの傷、許してやってね。悪気はないのだから。
OK。Some things are confirmed now with this, I think. She got the wound by the from a he or him or what you want to call him. The dude who blocked all the fireballs and magic stuff and so on. And he is affiliated with this other person, with this woman, and probably they are also the people who appeared in Hinata's dream.
So then, the broken area is getting healed.
Nigel frowns and points his chin towards the inner part of the room. Her? Where's the inner part of the room side? Sits a giant tank. Does he mean someone's inside there? Masumi both tilts her head to the side and bows toward the tank. That instant I almost swear I hear a bubbling sound echo from inside the tank. That's when I reach towards the rosary at my chest.
Sate, don. Kore de medetaku, dennō fukatsu da ne. Omedetō.
We leave Nurgle's shop and head back to the apartment where everyone awaits.
So desu ne.
For some reason, Masami's expression doesn't clear up.
Dou shita no? Doko ka chōshi ga warui no?
Ie, tada.
Tada?
Hii to ii, sakki no josei to ii. Netto ni wa joujin o haruka ni chōetsu shita. Watashi ga tachi uchi dekinai hodo.
I see. For someone as proud as Masami, the realization that their own biocomputer is a potential victim for interference must be quite humiliating. Masami bites her lip out of charge. I bring Masami into a gentle embrace.
何言ってるの？当然じゃない。全員揃って初めて天下無敵のクリミナルなんだから。
リーダー。
Masami buries her face in my chest. Her shoulders shiver ever so slightly.
サミほど切れるアタッカーはいないよ。だからさ、一緒にまたネットに潜ろう。ね。
はい。私。
Yeah, it's okay. Cried out loud.You're not alone, your friends are with you. We can get through this together. For we are united as a team. Through the fun times and the rough, we've come through this all together. We are each an inseparable part of a single entity.
Minna, tadaima!
Extraction, compression. Okay. I think this is it for now. And yes, I will hope to meet you in the next episode. And I think the next episodes could lead to the end. Because if we look at the this here, only goes to the Moon Age of 23. So we made choices, and Here we are already at the 27th. Will be really, really exciting. What will happen? Okay, then I would like to meet you in the next part and stay healthy.